I don't think Revit was made for electrical engineering, to be completely honest. One example is when working with conduits. There is often complaints with the materials or parameters applied to conduits and their accessories. So I made a small Revit tool to try to improve that. Let's jump into Revit. I've prepared two samples to show you. So in the first one, I'm going to show how to deal with changes in parameters in conduit runs. And in the second one, how to apply different materials to all the fittings and conduits in the same run. So in the first one, well, I set some values for some of these parameters. So we have, for example, an image here and some other comments, mark, and a new parameter that I created as well. As you can see, the other parts of the conduits do not have any value. So if we do have some changes in parameters, this tool is quite helpful, so you can actually copy all the parameter values to the entire run. So I'm going to run parameter material and parameter conduits. And what this is going to do, yeah, I'm going to unselect this one. This will be in the second use case. And what this is going to do is going to detect all the connections to the part of the conduit that I select. And it's going to copy all the instance parameters to the other parts. This will only work with the group's identity data and facing. So if you have like new parameters here, like new part, for example, here, these values will be copied. But if you have other groups or sections out of this one, those won't be copied. So great, I'm just gonna select that one, the one with the values, and then click on Apply Selection. And then as soon as I click, I can go to the other, well, to the other parts, and then we see that all the values has been copied. The mark value, well, the mark parameter was not copied because this is, as you may know, like a unique parameter. So if this is copied, this will prompt an error. For the second example, we do have, well, some conduits that have a parameter, and the fittings have a different material than the conduits. So what we can do is we can actually paint and copy the material between those. So if we want to copy the material from the fitting to the conduits, we can just select the fitting and then and select the parameter that we want to copy from. If we have several material parameters, we can select the one we want, and then if we want to create new material parameter for all the elements. Additionally, we can switch between instance and style parameters. Great, so if I want to copy from fitting, I'm just going to click on Apply and select. And then we see that all the connected parts have changed their material. But we could also go the other way around. If I select the conduit run and then click on the material parameter to copy to, this is nice because it's quite flexible if you have like different families with different materials. So if I select the straight part and then click on Apply Selection, we see that the fittings also change. And this is because the material we selected is right here and then the value was changed. But as I said, it does also work with different families of fittings and so on. So that's it. I hope you find this tool helpful. If you have like other ideas for other tools, I'm glad to hear them from you. Thanks for watching. Have a great day. Bye-bye.